Bolt action rifle for the medic class. Does it sound crazy enough? Maybe, but at the same time, we already got Fedorov, which is pretty much an assault rifle for the medic class, so at this point, nothing really surprises me. Guys, today we're gonna be taking a look at the brand new CTE update that I've also made a video about yesterday explaining the new operations, but today we will take a look at the two new weapon adjustments to the weapons which are already present in the game, but they got some improvements implemented. Yes, you've probably already heard, but those weapons are the General Liu rifle from the In the Name of the Tsar DLC and the M1903 Experimental from the Vanilla Battlefield 1. And also, as a bonus, I'll show you the brand new grenade launcher, which is only available in CTE and will not be available outside of it to play with, but it is a pretty interesting thing. It can hold 6 grenades at once and you spawn with 60 grenades. Yes, you literally do spawn with 60 grenades in your pocket. Now when I have your full attention, we can actually start off with talking about new weapons. Or new weapons after modifying the old weapons. Which pretty much means that the General Liu rifle can be currently used in two fire modes. It can be used in the old one, that being semi-automatic, but also you can switch it to the bolt action mode with increased damage per shot. The option of switching the fire mode itself has already been available back in the day in August of 2017, if I'm correct, during the testing of the In the Name of the Tsar DLC in the CTE, but back then, changing the fire mode didn't change anything. You were just shooting the weapon slower, but that didn't give you any advantage, so why would you actually do it? There was no point. Now, it actually has some point, because it's easier to take out enemies on the longer distances. It's actually funny, because about 2 weeks ago, I was discussing a question of how General Liu could be buffed in one of my videos. And I couldn't really come up with any idea, because I forgot that the weapon, in fact, had a bolt action mode 6 months ago. Or a lot more than that, actually. But now when I see it, it is actually a great option of making it not only unique, but also a lot better than the competition. Imagine, you can have both semi-automatic medic rifle and bolt action for taking out enemies on the longer distances. You can even 1v1 snipers with it, no problem. I can't really give you any details of its statistics after switching it to the bolt action mode, as those are not currently in the CTE yet. But it does seem like it has a lot higher damage per shot with the bolt action mode enabled. It also looks dope when it changes to the bolt action, just you can see the animation throughout the gameplay. After you switch to the bolt action mode, you still have 6 bullets in the magazine, but naturally as it's a bolt action, you have to reload after every single shot. Now, as I've mentioned at the beginning of this video, the M1903 Experimental has also gotten the same option. In fact, those two are pretty much identical. From now on, you can also switch it to the bolt action mode and use it as a proper sniper. Tons of players were asking DICE to implement the M1903 Infantry, and now they actually did within the experimental variant. Which, if you ask me, is more than great, considering that you basically can use two weapons at the same time. I have to admit that I simply love the idea of DICE actually coming up with such things and implementing them to the game. Not only does it make the weapons a lot more unique, but also it adds something new to the game and, let's be honest, it's something we haven't seen in the past. At least I have not. Alright. So now you know about the two new weapons, or actually two new adjustments to the old weapons. Now, what is that grenade launcher that I was talking about at the beginning of this video? You've probably already seen it in the gameplay that sometimes, or practically pretty much every single time I died, I was killed by the 6-shot grenade launcher. and I was also using it. How is that possible? Is this a new feature? Or is the game broken again? The option 2 is correct. It is a glitch, and currently, if you equip the grenade launcher, whichever it is, and then switch to the General Liu rifle, you will be able to shoot out 6 grenades, and what's even better, after you shoot them out, you can switch back to the General Liu, reload General Liu, and then, when you switch again to the grenade launcher, you will have it loaded with 6 new grenades. Which means, you basically can carry 60 grenades on the battlefield. Can you imagine fitting 60 grenades inside your pocket? Like, that's just insane. It is a glitch, so don't worry, it will never ever come to the vanilla game, but still, if you have access to the CTE on PC, I definitely do recommend to check it out. Trust me, it really feels good to shoot out 6 grenades at once from one grenade launcher. It's not that fun on the receiving side, but then again, it is worth it. And that would be it for this video, guys. Let me know down in the comments, what do you think about the new upgrade for both General Liu and the M1903 Experimental? Or should I actually say, M1903 Infantry? Make sure to check out the new grenade launcher in the CTE, trust me, it really is worth it. And as always, if you enjoyed, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and I see you on the battlefield!